After viewing the material from week one, I get a lot of questions from students trying to connect the dots of the bigger picture. And I typically find this explanation helpful. Here I have some points that are plotted in three dimensions. So imagine I have three variables, X, Y, and Z, and here are 500 observations along those variables. And so this is just a scatter plot. And as I rotate this data around, I learned that there's something interesting going on. And that's that this data is not really three-dimensional. It's two-dimensional data living in a three-dimensional world. This is what linear dependence looks like when there are three variables involved. An example might be looking at rectangular gardens and you have the length, the width, and the perimeter of those gardens. Because perimeter is 2 times length plus 2 times width. And you won't be able to uncover that through a simple correlation matrix because perimeter may be correlated with length and width. Length and width may be correlated, but not perfectly so. It's only when you take all three variables together that you have this perfect linear dependency. So if we wanted to solve a problem like this and examine this data, the thing we're realizing is that we don't really need three coordinates. However, we can't just take a subset of the variables that we have now. For instance, if I take Y and Z and I drop X, the picture that I would get would look something like this. If I take Y and X, and drop C, the picture I'd get would look something like that. But none of those gives me the full layout of the data. Indeed, when I take this angle shown here, I can see all the relationships between those data points perfectly. And by that, I mean the distance between the points is exactly what it is in three-dimensional space if I take this two-dimensional viewpoint. So what I want to imagine doing is kind of taking a poster board or a plane and sticking it through all of those data points and then plucking that plane out of three-dimensional space. And now I have this two-dimensional picture with my data points plotted on it. And if I were to put it on the wall and say, well, here are the three coordinates for these data points, people would look at me as if I had two heads because two-dimensional data should not have three coordinates. So what we need to do is on this poster board or on this plane, we want to draw new axes. And so, you know, kind of make the box in the back, the XYZ box in the back disappear from your minds and we would draw a new axis, maybe one going vertically here, one going horizontally. And technically I would have a third axis coming out of the computer screen. But the point is I don't need it because all of the coordinates along that third axis would be zero. And then once I find those new axes, I have a new set of coordinates along those axes. But my data is perfectly represented in that new coordinate system because it's essentially two-dimensional data. It's just not any pair of the two dimensions I had, X, Y, Z. It has to be written in a new basis to have a new set of coordinates. I hope that's helpful in allowing you to see the bigger picture.